This video is sponsored by my Etsy store, where you can find all kinds of cool spaceship scale models. Product range changes by time, but for you SpaceX fans, there will always be something offered. Link in the description. Last video, I made the Starship, and in this video, I'm going to make the Super Heavy. Somebody said in the comments that it would be nice if I talked you through the process. And I thought, why not? So here we go. First, I insert the pictures I found on the SpaceX website. I got a bottom view for the engines and a side view for the overall body. Those two are enough for me to make the Super Heavy. I make sure to align and scale them correctly. The bottom of the Super Heavy starts wide, goes up straight a little, then narrows to a final diameter. So I make a 100 millimeter circle on the original XY plane that I extrude, and I make a 90 millimeter circle on the offset plane. I use loft to connect the upper plane of the extrude with the 90 millimeter circle. Then I extrude it all the way up to the top. I draw one scratch in the form of the leg on the XY plane and a guideline on the ZX plane. I use the sweep function to create the leg. The leg has a cutout, so I draw a triangle and remove the excess material. I use the mirror and pattern functions as much as possible because I am lazy and it ensures consistency in the model. For the leg, I use a circular pattern, some edge fillet to remove sharp edges, now I create some space for the engines, which do not touch the ground. This will take the most time, even when using mirror and pattern functions as much as possible. At the root of the legs, there is also an engine, so I need to create space for them as well. The drawing did not cut into the legs, so I create a separate drawing on the leg and then make a cut. Now it's time to create the engines. First, I draw circles, which I extrude to create a base where the engine bells are attached to. For the last circle, the pattern function did not result in what I hoped, so I had to do it in two parts. For the engine bells, I use the revolve function. some of the engine bells, I create an angled plane so I can sketch it in the right position. Now it's time for the grid fins. I create a new plane at 45 degrees. Drawing the grid is a tedious job, which in the end did crash Fusion. So I'm now going for a far more simple design, which I will just eyeball. As long as I can show you how it's done, I'm fine with it. Thank you. I extrude the drawing and use pattern to create the other three grid fins. A circular cutout at the top, and we got ourselves a super heavy booster. This model is not designed for 3D printing, I just created it for the video. Keep an eye on my Etsy store because I'm working on a Starship project right now. I might drop a digital Starship model kit for people with a 3D printer in the near future on it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time. Spaceship Mania, signing out.